Welcome to Napoli. Welcome back to the Pala Cazoria. It is finals time on day two of the sparring here, and we have three weight categories, gold medals up for grabs. Here is the running order to the next three fights. We're starting with the men's under 58 kilograms, the gold medal bout, and then moving into the women's flyweight competition. The under 49 kilograms, then the women's under 67 kilograms. And they are all Olympic categories. It will be seen in Tokyo 2020 in just over a year's time. It means the field is intense. It's been a tough competition to get to this stage. Only the best that have been sent to Napoli have got through. So the first fight on, the men's under 58 kilograms, Tubin Paida Bolom against Armin Hadipur. The Mongolian studies in Ulaanbaatar at the Mongolian International University. On an international stage, though, the fighter in blue also carries a lot of respect. Asian Championship silver medalist from 2016. No easy task rising to the top in that competition. There he goes, spinning his way forward, landing the shots. He'll take a ganjong, but that has put him 2 points up with the spinning kick to the trunk, giving him 4 points. How patient was he throughout that first round? Then the guard was dropped. Lightning quick. Jabbing forward on that front foot. Landing the shots as well, Hadipur. 3 points for the headshot, takes him back into the lead. So dangerous, that front foot. Uses it to check and shot put on him by his opponent. See how Bolom keeps that right hand at the back. It always looks like he's poised to come in for the punch. There he goes with a spin, though. It's worked before, not that time. And he will allow Hadipur to go 1 point ahead. He'll get clawed back. Hadipur on the left. World ranking of 5 in the Olympic table. Bolom trying to ensure that he doesn't give his opponent any opportunity from in close. Loves to climb over the shoulder when he's in the clinch. As did Hosseini yesterday. So now tied up. Hadipur conceding a ganjong for holding on to his opponent. You can't do that. You can push them away when you're in this scenario, as long as you have the intention to then fire away a shot. Iranian back in the lead through another ganjong. It is the discipline, or the ill discipline, which is forcing the lead to change hands at the moment. 14 seconds left in the second round. Fighters in the middle distance, and Hadipur goes up high. Cheers from his corner. Shots not given, but his opponent stepping out of the boundary lines. Just 1 foot's required to mean you have to concede a ganjong. And it is 2 points the difference with a round still to go. Hadipur coming back from that spinning shot to the trunk against him. So 2 minutes to win it for one of these two. Just 2 points the difference. There goes the points landing. 3 of them for the Iranian. 2 points back for Bolon. And that checking front foot comes out and takes such good balance and endurance to be able to fight like that throughout the course of a day, throughout the course of a fight. Just going to have a challenge here from the Mongolian corner. So, cancelled out, the points will stay. Bolon representing all of Mongolia's chances here for a gold medal. He'll be his nation's first at the Universiade in 2019. Hadipur trying to be a history maker. That's a great shot from the Mongolian. Another spinning kick, landing on the trunk, tying things up. Now Hadipur is kicked into action and he lands. Good points, putting his opponent out, and he's going to get the count. Nodding that he's absolutely fine to the referee. And he'll take a gamjon for having stepped out, so the 7 points, the difference. That was superb from the Iranian. Stung, and then he stung back. 7 points the difference, a minute remaining. Hadipur trying to go forward, but so wary of that spinning back kick from Bolon. Points eked back a little bit. Just 5 points the difference now. Bolon again with that right arm in that coiled for a punch almost. Hadipur on the offensive, trying to break the distance. Then coming forward, that's a huge shot. He's leveled things up, brilliant from Bolon. Falling to the floor, so he incurs a gamjon. The Iranian still leads. And he adds another two. Calls for potentially that to be a challenge, but the card is gone, so there's no chance for it. 20 seconds remaining, the Iranian going upstairs, looking to land 3 points with the headshot. Plenty of time for Bolon in the blue to land another shot. He goes to the trunk there. That would give him the lead. Another shot to the trunk with a spin, and he beat in front with 10 seconds remaining. This final on a knife edge. Another shot, it doesn't register. Bolon coming forward. 1 second remaining. Last chance for the Mongolian. He has to go for it. Time is going to run out on him. What a final. Armin Hadipur from the Islamic Republic of Iran wins his third consecutive Universiade gold medal. He stepped up from fin weight to flyweight. In 2019, it is the same result. Oh, and how he had to do it the hard way. So effective on the counter-attack. The spinning kicks coming in from the blue corner, coming in from Bolon. But Armin Hadipur, 22-19, that was a thriller. For the Iranian camp, their second gold medal in the sparring. So, to the women's competition and the next gold medal bout on. Both fighters are students. Chuang studies at the National Taiwan Sport University. And Panipa Wong Patanakit, a sports science student. Imagine her schedule, a little bit difficult to manage with all the travelling around the world, which you need to do on the circuit to be number one. Wong Pantelakit coming forward off that front foot. And just switching stance and now going off the left leg. Punch coming in. As we see through this final, we will get a chance just to see the full range that Wong Pantelakit is able to cover with that front leg. It is otherworldly. Fighters just think they may be safe, but then that comes over the top, round the back, headshot, thank you very much. I think you've quelled the attack and then comes back at you from another angle. It is frightening. So unnerving. Especially when you're trying to settle into a fight and maybe find yourself 3 points down. That is the situation Chong is in. Other than that moment, both fighters just trying to eye each other up and work out where the weaknesses are. There aren't too many for Wong Pantelakit. She adds another 2 points with that front leg to the trunk. Just checking forward and then going for a little hook kick. And that'll be the first round and it's going with form. Wong Pantelakit, 5 points up. She's no stranger to close-run matches, is Chong Chien-Yu, because she came through her semi-final against Irina Romaldanova from the Ukraine. That was only really decided in the very closing seconds. And in her quarter-final, was only ahead towards the very end of that. Five down here, so no cause for alarm just from looking at the scoreboard. The alarm is the ease with which, when Wong Pantelakit wants to, she can use that front foot to devastating effect. In close enough for a punch. Doesn't quite land, and if there is a part of Wong Pantelakit's ability, it has been the punching, which has been a little soft, not registered too many times, not to impress the judges enough to award the punch, but that's no troubling adding another two with a shot to the trunk. Get a feeling that Chong is still thinking more about what her opponent is going to be doing and trying to avoid it and limit the damage than able to land her own shots. ...30 seconds remaining in the second round. Much less which Wong Pantelakit has done, because much less she's had to do. She's comfortably in the lead. Now she's trying to push her opponents, get a few nudges maybe, get a gamjong from Chong going outside the boundary lines. It is working for the Thai fighter. 2 minutes remaining in this women's flyweight final here at Naples 2019. The number one seed, Wong Pantelakit from Thailand in the blue. And from Chinese Taipei, Chong Chien-Yu in the red. Still, Chong is rocked back on that hind leg of hers. Just now she tries to come forward. Doesn't manage to because the counter is good, and that's 3 more points for Wong Pantelakit. There she goes round the back again. And it's a gamjong for holding. So a penalty points against Chiong. In her semi-final, Wong Patanakit won by over 20 points. No point gap victories being awarded in these latter stages, so the fight just went on and it became a training exercise for Wong Patanakit. It was a sensational way to enter a final. And she's just kicked on. Kicked on and kicked in and aimed for the head when she's got the chance. But within that, it is a disciplined performance. Gives her opponent that respect. Just knows she can live a little bit further away because she can then strike forward. Chiong bravely getting in close. It's another point added, that time with the punch. There goes another three. 20 seconds remaining. It has been another masterclass. The semi-final was in that category too. For Thailand. Panipa Wong Patanakit cruising towards this gold medal. Another Gamjon. And that will settle things. Great respect shown between the two. Throughout the fight, in the way it was conducted, there was never a doubt. Panipa Wong Patanakit is the gold medalist in the women's flyweight division. Another victory for this supreme taekwondo athlete. For Chueng Tianyu, another proud moment for her in her career, Chinese Taipei with the silver medal. Well, a two-time world champion, the reigning world champion from Manchester earlier this year, the Asian Games champion from last year. She's also the Universiade champion from back in 2017. She's performed on the Olympic level, bronze medalist at Rio 2016. And she is a true titan of her sport. Action. Confirmation of what we saw out on the mat. 17 points, total domination in a taekwondo fight. Congratulations. The final act of taekwondo here in the Palakazoria. We're going to be treated to a fine final in the women's welterweight competition. Shan Yun Yun against Magda Viet Enna. France against China. So Shan's part in her semi-final, it's a close-run thing, just 4 points to two. She came through against Anna Cicitu from Moldova. That was tight all the way through, so Shan won't mind this. Another 2 points added from the French fighter. Shan from the clinch tries to go up and over, tries to get the headshot. Both fighters trying to stay soft in the knees, trying to ensure that they can come in quickly and back away if need be. Feinting up high is Viet Enna and then spinning through, although it was the counter from Viet Enna that landed. So three shots to the trunk, the difference between these two fighters. 20 seconds remaining in the second. Viet Enna from France. Looking to add gold to the bronze medals she picked up in the World Championships. And that'll be the end. Well, Shan has been on her travels this year as well. She's a silver medalist from the Australia Open in Queensland earlier this year. No stranger to globetrotting. Trying to pick up ranking points wherever you can. The road to Tokyo 2020 for both these two fighters very much on their mind. Vietena has that motivation of trying to do something her mother was not able to do and compete in an Olympics in taekwondo. She's added another 2 points from that exchange. Tries to clash that in. It is the power with which she lands them, which means that for the number of times she goes in for a shot, gets points back quite frequently. Good block there with the left arm on Shan's right leg. 1 minute remaining in this final. Still the 8 point difference. Shan Yunyun may need to let her legs go if she's to come out on top here. Two spinning kicks to the head would put her straight into the lead. That only takes 10 seconds or so, but does she have it in her game? Does she have the ability to fly at the head of Vietena? Currently just trying to work off that front foot still. 30 seconds remaining. Anna Gamjon for use of the knee. Vietena from France. Edging so close now to this gold medal. Brings in the feints. Still conscious of where the shots are going to come from, but now she has to fight in close. 10 seconds remaining, 9 points the difference. Vietena just happy to see it out. And Shan Yunyun happy to take it. Well, a worthy winner. Magda Vietena. The strategy paying off, the ability to strike at the right time, giving her the margin of victory, in which in the end, Shan Yunyun just conceded because she couldn't make it back. Magda Vietena from France takes the gold medal. And it is the tricolour flag which she waves through the air here at the Palais Cazorla. France will stand atop the podium in the taekwondo competition. It will be that beaming smile of Magda Vietena. 9 points to nil in the final. It was a comprehensive fight from Magda Vietena. Well, wherever you've been watching from, we're delighted to have had your company here in the Palais Cazorla. Thanks very much for joining and have a very good evening.